I am therefore going to hand over now to our host, the Vice Chancellor of the University of Pretoria and its principal, Professor Carly Pistorius.
Thank you very much, Asha. Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. As the Vice Chancellor of the University of Pretoria here in South Africa, it is really a privilege for me to be able to welcome you here to this Climate Justice Dialogue. We are greatly indebted to the Global Humanitarian Forum in Geneva for the opportunity of collaborating with them in hosting the Climate Justice Dialogue here at our university this afternoon. Ladies and gentlemen, you're all very welcome, but allow me to mention a few special guests and welcome them specifically. First of all, Mr. Kofi Annan, the President of the Global Humanitarian Forum and Nobel Prize laureate, who will be participating via the video link, as you saw. We are delighted to have with us the Archbishop Emeritus Desmond Tutu, also a Nobel Prize laureate, who we are delighted to also welcome as an alumnus on the campus. The Archbishop received an honorary doctorate degree from the University of Pretoria some years back. I was also delighted to hear that he's the patron of the Wilberforce Institute for Slavery and Emancipation at the University of Hull, but that's another story for another day. We have with us a very eminent person, very welcome to Mrs. Mary Robinson, the president of Realizing Rights, the Ethical Globalization Initiative. And she, of course, is also an old friend of ours. She is an extraordinary professor at the University of Pretoria, which is very closely involved with our Center for Human Rights and also the Center for the Study of AIDS here at the university. Then, of course, our MC, Ms. Nisha Pillay, the news anchor of the BBC World, who has kindly agreed to act as our moderator for today's dialogue. Mr. Martin Frick, Mr. Jay Goodman, Mr. Marcus McKenzie, all from the Humanitarian Forum on Geneva, who have been very closely and actively involved in the arrangements for today's event. And of course, I'd like to welcome from the University of Pretoria the executive, members of the executive, the deans, the staff members from our university, particularly Professor Dion Rousseau, who's been very closely involved in the arrangements. Also staff from other universities who are with us today, as well as other visitors with special expertise, knowledge, and keen interest in the topic of global justice. And then lastly, but certainly not the least, to all the students. The Global Humanitarian Forum specifically indicated that they would want to have students with us, and of course we would have it in no other way. So to all the students from this university and other student universities who are here, thank you very much for your attendance. And then of course to members of the media, you're always welcome at this university. Ladies and gentlemen, as most meetings on global warming take place in the Northern Hemisphere, I think it is really a great privilege for the University of Pretoria to host this event in the South. And what makes this event even more exceptional is that it focuses on the human impact, something that is regarded by many Africans as a perhaps neglected issue in some sense, but that is of great concern in Southern Africa. And it is my wish that this dialogue will encourage positive debate around climate justice in a region that has least contributed to greenhouse gas pollution, but that appears to be significantly affected by climate change. In the South African context, the University of Pretoria is very well positioned, I think, to address many of the challenges that climate change poses. Because with its diversity of faculties, which include the Faculty of Natural and Agricultural Sciences, aspects of social studies, the legal environment, economics, and health sciences, and with our extensive international collaboration, the University of Pretoria has a very special focus on climate-related issues. Community engagement in particular is becoming an increasingly important activity whereby this university expresses not only its local relevancy, but also its local impact. And through the existing and future communication and engagement channels to communities, research on climate change impact could provide very valuable information to local communities on adapting or even getting more involved in mitigation actions. The University of Pretoria is also actively involved in long-term planning initiatives by the National Department of Science and Technology, the DST, for addressing future global change in all our natural resources. And the DST, you might know, has identified global change to be one of the five priority so-called grand challenges on which to focus over the next 10 years. On an academic research level, many sophisticated climate simulation models and studies have been completed by this university. And this has contributed significantly to local and international knowledge of the risks that future climate change might hold for Southern Africa. Other studies that have been conducted to assess the impact of global warming on agriculture and food security, while new initiatives will focus on the impact of social society, water availability, and even economic consequences. You might know that we also recently established the Benfield Chair for Environmental Risk Hazards. I believe that today's climate justice dialogue aims to address an equally important aspect of climate change, the impact that it will have on social society. And therefore, this meeting offers the opportunity whereby information can be spread to students and staff and researchers, but most importantly, also to people across the world who eventually will have to face the consequences if we don't start acting in a responsible way in creating a sustainable living environment for our children. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for attending, and you're all very welcome.